square root of a number. Examples of division method. Hello friends, welcome to this video. In the previous video, we learned to find the square root of a perfect square number by the division method and to calculate the number of digits in its square root. In this video, we will see some examples associated with the division method of finding the square root. Let's look at the first example. There are 961 chairs in the hall. They are to be arranged in such a way that each row should have as many chairs as the total number of rows. So can you guess how many rows will be made in this way? Here, we have to arrange 961 chairs in such a way that each row has as many chairs as the total number of rows. But this would be possible only if the total number of chairs we have been given here is a perfect square number. If it is a perfect square, then its square root gives us rows and chairs in each row. Let us find the square root of 961 using the division method. First of all, we will draw lines like this around the number 961 and then put bars on it. The number of digits in this number is odd, so there will be only one digit below the leftmost bar. Now, we will find a number whose square is equal to or smaller than 9, that is, the number below the leftmost bar. Here that number is 3. 3 is the divisor of this number and also the first digit of the quotient. Write 9 below the first number and subtract both. Here we are getting 0. We will write the number below the next bar next to the received remainder. Now leave a blank space for the units place of the new divisor and multiply the digit in the units place of the first divisor by 2. After this, write the resulting product beside the blank in this way. To fill this blank, we will find the largest digit that will be the new digit of the quotient and multiply the new divisor by this new digit of the quotient. The product will be either less than or equal to the factor. The digit 1 will be put in the blank space because 61 times 1 is equal to 61, which is equal to the new factor. Thus, the remainder will be 0. Now there are no digits left in the given number. Thus, we are getting 31 as square root of 961. So, the hall will have a total of 31 rows of chairs and each row will have 31 chairs. Let us now see another example. Find the smallest natural number which, if added to 1000, gives us a perfect square number. If you want, you can pause the video here and solve the question. The number 1000 is not a perfect square number. Can you guess why? This is because the number of zeros at the end of this number is odd, and we know that the number of zeros at the end of any perfect square number is always even. To solve this question, let us first find the square root of the number 1000 using the division method. We can see here that we have got 39 as the remainder. The remainder here is not a zero, so 1000 will not be a perfect square number. That is, here the quotient is 31. This shows that the square of 31 is smaller than 1000. Because the number 32 is larger than the number 31, so the square of the number 32 will also be larger than 31. The square of 32 is 1024. This means the square of the next whole number, 32, will be larger than 1000. So, by adding the number 24 to 1000, we will get a perfect square number 1024. In this video, we saw some examples associated with the division method of finding the square root. In the next video, we will see some common mistakes associated with them. Thank you.